sure to cook. Today we're gonna be doing meatball subs. We're gonna do everything homemade. Then I'm gonna add a little Creole seasoning inside of there. It's gonna give this a great stare.
That guy's looking good to go.
I hear you. Yes. Oh my God, that is wonderful. So that was about 4 to 5. Come back. Bye. Welcome back to another episode of Be Sure to Cook. Today we're making an old classic, my kids' favorite classic. We're making fried chicken wings with steamed cheese broccoli and sweet rice. So stay tuned and let's do this. Okay, on the stove I got 2 cups of boiling salt water that is boiling, and I'm gonna add some long grain white rice, and I'm gonna add about 1.5 cups of long grain white rice, close to 1/2, so about 1.5 cups, yeah, that's what I'm gonna add. Add to 2.5 cups of boiling water with salt in it. Okay, let's get over here and stir this in. Let's get this going. Okay, adding in the rice to that boiling hot water. Gonna give it a couple of stirs. It's got about 1 teaspoon of salt in there. Okay, let's let that go. Let's get our chicken together. Okay, I have some chicken wings and they're already soaking in a salt brine. So all I did was add some sea salt to some water, put my chicken wings in here, and I just let them sit in here for about 1 hour or so while I was doing other things. So I've already rinsed a nice salt solution. So these are like double washed. So now I'm gonna rinse these all. I'm gonna just dump this salt out of here, and I'm gonna fold these wings and get them ready for us to start battering. Okay, so what I did when I put the rice in, I let it boil hard, then I turn it down onto a simmer and let it. And I do want all this starch because I want this to cook off. And it's this right here is a recipe that I've always grew up with my family. And we call it just sweet rice, but actually it's just sticky rice, and it's cooked down with water. And then after the water reduced, I put heavy cream in it, and I cook it with heavy cream and get the flavor of the heavy cream, adding butter, lots of butter and sugar. And it's like a sweet rice. It's kind of like you would make maybe rice pudding in a way, maybe, because some people might put nuts in it, or you can put raisins or something like that. A lot of people do that, but it's just butter and just real thick heavy cream, and it's really good. And I grew up with this, and my kids grew up with it and they love it. I mean, you might not like it, you don't have to eat it, but this is something that we like. Every little family has their own little thing that people like to eat. I've seen a lady that her family they love to eat I don't like it, but they love to eat like onion sandwiches. Somebody used to like to eat lettuce sandwiches. Ours is like sweet rice. You might have somebody that have, you know, maybe yogurt and, you know, bananas or something. Everybody has their own little thing that they have that, you know, it brings them back from when they were younger children. So this is ours, sweet rice. So we're going to let this cook, and I'm going to show you how to finish this up. Okay, after I drain off majority of the water and I've been shaking and draining off, I'm gonna add a big amount of garlic powder, and I'm gonna flop these babies around, and I'm like gonna massage these chickens. So they're just wings. I just massage them with, you know, a little bit of garlic powder. And I'm just gonna keep on doing that. And if you see any imperfections on your chicken, like a wing, like a feather, hanging out of a wing or whatever, just pull that off and disregard that. You're still going to cook them. They're still rinsed. It's just a, you know, it's just a feather that might be sticking out. And I do see 1 or 2, and I'm going to take that. But I'm just going to massage these, and I'm going to leave these sit for another couple of minutes while I'm getting ready to get my broccoli together. this is a little of my chicken seasoning mix that, I mean, well, it's not, it's a flour base. So this is mine. And let me tell you, it's just regular old flour, and it's just the regular old flour, all-purpose flour. And I'm adding red pepper, which is cayenne pepper, but they call it red pepper. If you can't find the, it's saying cayenne, just get the red pepper. You know, that's the same thing as cayenne. And I'm using obey, white pepper, seasoned salt, onion powder, Mrs. Dash blend, ground garlic powder, and paprika. And what you probably want to add, about a teaspoon of each in there. Whip that right up. Make sure you whip it up really good. Always taste it. And don't forget, I mean, well, you know, you don't need salt if you're using, you know, seasoned salt, because that's salt. Take a little bit. I know you might not like it. Put a little bit on your hand or your finger and just do a taste. If you don't like that, that's fine. But it tells you how well, you know, your flour is seasoned. Because if this doesn't taste good to you while you're tasting it like I just told you to taste it, then it's not going to, I mean, you don't know what it's going to taste like, and you don't know what it's going to taste on your chicken. But if you say, oh, that's pretty good, and then you taste and you need more salt, or you need a little bit more cayenne pepper, or you want to put a little bit of more seasons of each of them in there, it'll tell you how good this tastes. If it tastes good to you, it's going to taste good on your chicken. Okay, after these have been sitting so that garlic can soak into that chicken, you can sit it for about a 30 minutes, an hour. It depends on whenever you're ready to cook the chicken. We're going to take it, we're going to take this wing, and we're going to fold it behind its back, and we're going to press on it hard and make sure it sticks. Sometimes they pop open, you know, you have a blowout is what I call them, because when they get in the fryer, they're greasy, it just blows and they pop and they spread their wings like this. See, this is out, so I can't do that with that one because the wing part is gone. So it's going to take that, oh, it lost the wing, and you're going to just fold it in the back. So you take your chicken and you take the wing and you do it like a four, and you bring it and you press it back, and you could hold it, and that wing will catch on. See, when you see those little feathers, just take it off. It'll catch on and hold it like a little four. Okay, now here's the rice. We had to go back to our rice because it was trying to stick because the water has already got out of here, and that's good. Okay, so the next thing, we're gonna have some cream, and you can use heavy cream. So we're gonna use about a half cup of heavy cream. Well, the rest of this is nothing but a half cup. So a half cup of heavy cream, and heavy cream is what they call it. It's just heavy whipping cream. And see how milky and silky that look? And we're gonna put that in there. And then we're gonna add about tablespoons of butter. That's one. And that's two tablespoons of butter. We're gonna let that melt in there, and that really heavy cream. And we got this on very, very low now, and we're putting the rest, there's no more milk in here, so we're just finishing this milk up. So it's heavy cream, heavy whipping cream is what this is. You could try a half cup sugar, so just do a half cup, and take a half cup and like separate the half cup, stir it in there, taste it, taste how sweet you like it. Some people might not like it as sweet. So I am using a different type of sugar. I'm using a low-fat diet sugar, which is for like people that are, you know, have like sugar problems or whatever. And I like that, so I'm already doing that earlier. So it's a low-calorie, sweet, and low sugar. So this is a half cup of sugar, which you don't have to use that much. But if you don't like that taste, a lot of people don't like that taste, but I do, because you can get prepared. You know, you got to get prepared for whatever you eat in the future, like right now. You know, if you're eating a lot of fat, a lot of grease, a lot of butter, you know, it does things to you. So whatever affects you, what you eat now, affects you in the future. So you might have a lot of health problems coming on if you eat a lot of that stuff. But if you try to cut down on it now, it saves you in the future. Okay, so now I put a small amount of water into a pan, and I'm going to add some sea salt to it, about a tablespoon of sea salt. And I've got this pan that I'm going to sit in the bottom of this, And I'm going to put my broccoli in here, and it's going to steam it. Bring the steam up and bring that up to a boil and getting that salt water into the vegetables and steaming. You can do this with, you know, medley, which is, you know, carrots, broccoli, cauliflower. I'm just doing broccoli today, but this is how I'm going to, I'm going to steam it, and I'm going to put this top on here, and it's going to make a big steam, and it's going to cook my vegetables this way. So let's get our water together, and right now we're going to heat it up while we drop our chicken wings into the flour and into the hot grease. Okay, now I'm going to start battering my chicken, putting a couple of pieces in here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I usually do about 6 wings, 6 good wings, and I'm going to open it, take it up. Okay, so I'm going to start battering all these. Well, you know, flouring them, battering them, they all the same. You're still putting a coating on something. Alrighty. And we want to make sure we really get these nice and coated really good. Okay. Then we're going to drop them in this hot grease. I think this grease is probably about 350 degree grease. Okay, I walked over towards my grease. I'm telling you. That cayenne pepper is like really, really strong, and it will blow you away just smelling it. So if I was you all, I wouldn't do take a half teaspoon of that. Do 1/4 teaspoon of cayenne pepper, and I will make sure he has that on that, you know, on this recipe here, because that would be just too hot. I mean, that is something, that is nothing to play with. I mean, it is something to play with, but that is hot and spicy. Unless you like hot and spicy, then you can do it. But I would use 1/4 teaspoon. That's not that much. Give you a little kick, but not that much where it's going to knock you out. Okay, so here's my wings. How you test your grease is you drop a little bit of, see me doing that? And see how that's bubbling up? That means those are ready. So let's drop these wings. We're shaking them out, and we're dropping those wings in there. And you want to make sure you turn that down, because you don't want it too hot, because if it's too hot, then it'll start like overcooking. Now, the only reason why I lifted it off the grease, because I didn't want that chicken grease to start, you know, popping up and overflowing. So I took it off to let it calm down, still left it at the same temperature that I have the stove. And I just started putting them in there until it calmed down. I put them right back on, and I just wanted them still to be still cooking the same speed. I just didn't want the grease to overflow over my little pan. This is an old little pan. I've been cooking for years with this, and I just clean it, wash out. It's old, but it's got a lot of flavor because it's just deep fried with nothing but chicken. It's my chicken pot. So we're frying that. Let's get to that broccoli. Okay, I have these big bags of steamables. It's just regular old broccoli, but you can get like a big thing of broccoli. And these are florets. I'd like the florets. Chopped broccoli, I really just don't care too much for them. I like the florets. And these are big size bags of florets. It's steamable, you know, broccoli. You can take these and actually put these in the microwave, and there you go. But I don't. I take them out. Here they are. They're frozen, and let me tell you what I'm going to, let's go over here, and I'm going to show you how to steam pot them. Okay, and I'm just going to take them and dump them into my pot here. And it's already steaming, already got it's hot. And I just take it and just put all these broccoli swirls right on in here. They usually do fit, but some of these broccolis are a little bit bigger. But honey, it's all going to go up in here. And I'm going to let this steam. Ooh, these are big pieces. Little pot, big piece. These are big broccoli. These are going to cook down. You're like, ooh, how's she getting all this broccoli in here? I am, but guess what? That's because it's going to cook down because they're frozen. Okay, told you I was going to get that. This is the tip that you pick it up with. But I'm just going to lay this down because it's so much. This is going, you see how this is? This is stuffed with 2 big bags of broccoli in their whole. I'm going to just lay the top on top of this. I've got this pan up. I got it up on high and it's getting ready to steam really bad. Watch this broccoli go down. You think this is a lot of broccoli, and actually it's not. So let's wash our pans, because I've been washing dishes, and I've been cleaning as I go. So let me clean up this mess that I have with the broccoli, and let's wash up all these dishes, and let's see how this broccoli looks in the next 15 minutes. Okay, I just got some square American, you know, cheese. I got about four slices of cheese. And you can use anything, you know, any kind of cheese, your favorite, you know. This is Kraft, but I always freeze my cheese. I'm going to use about a tablespoon of butter and about just a little milk to get that nice and creamy. And I'm going to microwave this to make a cheese sauce. I'm going to put more cheeses in there. Okay, so I'm going to start taking out some of my chicken here. And I'm going to lay them on my rack. And don't that look like award-winning chicken? It's just chicken. My chicken. You know, my flour mix. You can make your own. If you don't like any of the seasons that I put in my flour mix, you can make up your own seasons. You know, you want that crispy look. Want that nice golden brown look. And I am going to be adding in some more. I'm going to be keep on frying away. I'm doing nothing but wings today, so I'm making the wings. And then, oh, I see a crispy. See, look at that. People love crispies. So I'm going to add that on there. And before I take that one out, I want that just a little bit more darker because that must have been on the top. In the meantime, I'm going to be flouring up my other pieces. And before I put those in there, I'm going to take that out. All right, steamed broccoli, I turn that off, and it's nothing. See, that water, I'm putting this into a pot, and believe me, this is really steamed, and this is burning my hand. Woo! Woo! That burnt, but that's okay. I'm used to hot. I'm always dealing with hot. Look at me. My hands are, I think they just made for hot stuff. Because this is actually hot and it's smoking. And I'm just used to dealing with normal hot than everybody. Some people can deal with all that, especially if they deal with it all the time. And this is the water. See, it's just a little bit of water and it's had a lot of salt in it and it just came up and gave that great flavor. And here you go. Okay, then after I melted it a little bit, I'm gonna come back in here again and I'm gonna hit it with about maybe 1/4 cup of sharp cheddar back into the microwave. Okay, my broccoli and I'm melting the cheese. But guess what, guys? I'm still using my Smart Balance butter. It supports healthy cholesterol levels and everything. Don't forget, I'm always using that, no matter how much butter. I'm putting about 2 tablespoons of butter right on into this broccoli, and I'm gonna flip this broccoli. Just doing a flip, let all that heat. Gonna melt that broccoli on top of that. Yeah. And put that top back onto my little thing. I'm gonna let that sit while I go stir my cheese. I took this out and it was so hot I had to let it just cool just a little bit so I can touch. Here is my steamed broccoli. You remember that butter at the bottom? See? Look at that. See that butter at the bottom? Yeah, I'm just gonna toss that. I'm not gonna actually mix, I'm just gonna toss. I just want everything tossed. Okay, yeah, look at that. Still kind of hot, still kind of melted. I'm gonna toss that. Okay, now, remember that? And then I'm just gonna pour all that cheese. Woo, this is a little hot, guys. Yep, it's steaming on my hand. Oh. Okay, so I just went ahead and started to put all that cheese on there, and I'm just gonna toss it. I'm trying to toss it because I don't want to break it up, because sometimes you gotta watch that steam. That steam cooks really fast. Before you know it, you'd have been overcooked your broccoli. But I don't want that. I just want the good taste of this, that butter in there melted with it, so I can loosen up that cheese. Because don't forget, I did use American cheese slices and shredded cheddar with butter. Okay, here we go. We have our broccoli and cheese sauce, and our cheese sauce is got our broccoli at the bottom and our cheese sauce is on top, and we just gonna, all you have to do when you do this is you just wanna toss this and let all the cheese sauce get in there. We have our fried chicken wings, in our sweet creamy rice. Let's plate this up. Here we have it. Fried chicken wings, cheese and broccoli sauce, and our sweet rice. There you go, a dinner made for anybody. You could be anywhere, eat it anytime. Hey guys, I hope you like our show today and I hope you come back for another episode. Please like, share, and subscribe to our show. Here it is. We made this, you and me. We did this together. Chicken wings, sweet rice, and broccoli and cheese. We threw in some rolls for just extra. Hey, see you next time. Bye.